ABC 10 News at 11 starts now.
Man wanted in connection with several shootings died in a shootout with Chula Vista police. Hello and welcome. I'm glad to have you here. I'm Jim Patton. It happened in the driveway of a home with a family inside. ABC 10 News anchor Mary McKenzie joining us spoke to one of the family members who shared their terrifying ordeal and the quick thinking that kept the armed gunman from running into their home.
This family is incredibly lucky. They heard the car crash about 5:30 last night here in front of the house. Before they could think, though, the shootout was happening right in their driveway. There were small children inside the home, as well as the parents and the grandfather we talked to. Now, some of their tires you can see are flat because of some of the shots fired between the suspect and police, but none of them penetrated the house.
I didn't have time to be kind or nice. I had to shove them in, my wife and my granddaughter, into a closet and told them to be quiet and just stay low. Don't come out just until I tell you. And then I tried to just watch from a corner, a far distant corner.
Mark Iteraldi says his son-in-law had the quick thinking, presence of mind to shut the door and prevent David Angulo from coming inside the home. But his family still came face to face with the man Chula Vista police say was an armed attempted murder suspect and known gang member. He had just led them on a chase in a truck he had carjacked, they say, all while trying to evade police who were attempting to arrest him for at least three shootings just in the month of June. Angulo lost control of the F-150 pickup here in front of the home, smashing into an active duty military member who was seriously hurt. He then ran up the family's driveway and began firing at officers. The exchange of gunfire, Mark says, went on for several minutes. Police not even able to warn the family to get down before they were forced to fire. Mark credits his son-in-law, as did Chula Vista police, for keeping this from becoming a hostage situation or worse. There is a lot of video, including body-worn cameras. The investigation is ongoing. They don't know how many shots were fired, but that will be revealed, they promise, in a timely manner. None of the three officers who were involved were hurt. The family says they found five casings in their backyard, so they are grateful to police. They also offered their condolences to the family of David Angulo, even though he put their family in danger last night. In Chula Vista, Mary McKenzie, ABC 10 News.